the show. You met Geoff, clearly, then.
His hand is on my chair.
Yeah. You're the man, Craig.
We're still working it out a little bit.
His hands broken?
No, he's a skeleton. He's doing that because I think he's gay. He's got certain mannerisms that...
You're the man, Craig.
You know what? I gotta be honest. He makes me this much perturbed.
Perturbed?
Yeah,
do
you know why?
Why?
Because I kind of always thought that I would be your Ed McMahon.
No, you can't be my side.
Why not?
You're too cute. Everyone would watch you instead of me.
I could not totally do it. I have more than 8 catchphrases. Kevin. Not that you're not great. I'm just saying.
You're the man, Craig.
Yeah, all right. Thanks.
I'm just saying. It hurt my feelings a little bit because I was like, oh, bummer. I always kind of thought that's what I wanted to do with my life.
What, be a sidekick on a second-rate PBS
Craig, I was
show
born to be
like
a
this?
Sidekick.
What?
I was born to be a sidekick.
No. You're not. You're a leading lady. You should be out there tripping the light fantastic. Or just tripping.
Yeah, you've got a very nice spine. I've never noticed your spine.
It's a pretty decent average spine.
No, you're selling yourself. Sorry,
well,
let me have a look at that.
Thank you very much.
Whoa, look at that puppy right there. I bet you've got a really awesome skeleton in there.
Speaking of my arch nemesis.
He's not your arch nemesis.
Isn't he? Isn't he, though?
No.
Nice podium, Geoff. Because I wanted to be your co-host. I explained this to you last time.
Right.
And he put in his application at the same time I did. And, you know, he got the job, and that's fine. And then you demoted him because now he's no longer sitting next to the guest because he's what? He's creepy.
No. It's not because he's creepy.
Isn't it?
No, it's because there he's nearer an outlet.
And you gave him a snake mug?
Yeah, I gave him a snake mug, yeah. Well, you know why? Casting couch.
What?
Oh, yeah.
It was
out there. Kristen, I want to be taken seriously. Geoff, I want to be a sex object. Who do you think gets the job?
Well played. Well played, Craig. Hello, Geoff.
Ooh, hi.
Ooh, hi to you.
Ooh, you know, this movie is all about rivalries. Is there any way you and I can bury the hatchet?
I don't think so, Geoff. This rivalry is going to go on for a long, long time until I fill your seat.
Oh, I'd like to fill your seat. Let me just ask you something. Who are you wearing in your pants?
Geoff, you son of a...
How dare you?
Just watch your back.
Uh-oh. Back to you, Craig. In your pants.
Oh, we have to go. It's commercial break
time. Okay, bye.
You go and I'll do the monologue, and then when I get done, come back. And you can do the... We'll just do the whole show.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
Well, you walk over there.
Okay. Hi, Geoff. Hey, Geoff.
Oh, hey.
Are you guys still at this? This is ridiculous.
Geoff, this doesn't concern you, Craig. Did you have fun in Vegas?
Yeah, had a great time.
They say that anyone can get laid in Vegas. Did you finally disprove that theory?
What the hell is wrong? Why?
This doesn't concern you, Craig.
Don't be hating on the robot. He's an appliance. You come here, you're always angry at the robot. It's ridiculous.
Did anyone confuse him with a slot machine and stick a quarter up his butt?
Oh, yeah.
Yes,
they did.
Did you win any money?
No, I don't gamble at all. I'm a corrupt old...
I'm not that young.
Oh, yeah, you are.
How old do you think I am?
About 43. Those things that used to be in your grandma's house. Do you know what I mean?
Those little things that are filled with ink?
Yeah. What are they called
again? My grandma didn't have them. Those are like
squid.
On your business manager's desk, and they just sit there.
Oh,
you see that in movies when people are getting fired and they just zoom in on that little thing. Time is ticking away till you're canned.
You painted a scenario there.
I'm a storyteller, Craig.
Yes, you are. You should go on that VH1 show.
Which one? Storytellers?
Yeah.
All right, when the
pilot's Unplugged. Done. I want to see Geoff on Unplugged.
Yeah. Oh, boy.
All right. All right. Well, we're done here again. It goes so quickly when you're here.
It really does.
Yeah, it really does. I'm terribly sorry.
You got to get a new tooth.
Yeah, I'm taking them to a fake snake dentist later. Yeah, I'm getting it capped.
You should get a gold tooth.
You should give me a gold tooth with your money from House of Pies.
Okay. I'll get you a gold tooth.
Get me a gold tooth from a snake, and then I'll know that our love is real.
Okay.
All right.
Fair enough. And so will Geoff.
And so will Geoff.
Yeah. Hey, Kristen, look, I'm ticking away till your segment's over. Tick, tick, tick. Tick, tick, tick.
All right, that's enough. Don't be rude. Sometime. Not yet. I've got it. I like to. The really good shows like that, I rack them up. And what the hell?
Hey.
I just said hello. I was being cordial. You and then you watch them on TiVo, blah, blah, blah.
House organ here. Have you blown it before?
Nope.
Okay.
Do you want to blow it?
I'll give your organ a little toot if you want me to. You want me to? I'll try it. I don't think this is a very good one. You know how I can tell? The weight. That's how you can tell
the weight,
because if you hold an organ in your, you feel the weight of the, feel the weight of it. See that? That's disappointing, isn't it?
It almost flies.
Right. It's flight. Hey, don't be mad at Geoff. I thought you'd done with this.
I'm done, and you know what? I have an embarrassing story to tell you, Geoff. So when we were in Paris, it's like I can barely stand him. I got you a pen that looked like a baguette pen, and then I lost it. So I made you a baguette pen.
How charming. But do you want me to eat it, or are you going to bring it over here?
Don't go over there.
Can he write?
Can he write? You bet he can.
So there you go.
I don't know. Oh, thank you very much.
I figured, I know you're probably going to... I know you're probably going to fire Geoff.
I'm not going to fire Geoff. Oh, I forgot you, Geoff H.
Probably before the end of the show.
No.
So I figured we wanted to have something to remember him by.
I can hear you, Bill.
Yeah. I'm sorry, I forgot that you two hate each other. He's all right. He's fine. Look at him.
He's all right.
But this is great.
That's pretty cool.
This might actually work better in the new place, Geoff, I'm thinking.
How dare you?
Yeah, his job was fine until you went overboard with Caesar's penis. I think this would work. Like, you got a close up of this, right? Give me a close up of this.
It's pretty cool.
Right, and then watch.
That's right, Craig.
Yeah, that would work out just right. I'll put it up in the mantelpiece.
Okay,
wait right there. There you are. Ooh, that fire's hot. Oh, Kristen, but listen, you should have worn that dress when we went to Paris. Did you get it in Paris when we were there?
No.
Oh, it looks very Parisian.
Well, does it?
Yeah.
Thanks.
It looks very sophisticated, like, I would like a baguette.
I would like a baguette.
Oh, see, I love it when you talk French.
Well.
We had a nice time in Paris, didn't we?
Yeah, we did.
And you, Geoff, never got along, really.
No, but you know what? Now I'm a mom, and I want to sweep everything under the rug. I forgive you, Geoff.
Thank you. I forgive you, too, for what you did to me.
What did you do to him?
So difficult to deal with, Craig. Honestly, I thought I was going to be able to forgive him, and he's so annoying.
Okay. What the hell's going on?
Oh, she knows. Look, I'm somebody's mom, too, okay?
No, I think it's time for us to let bygones.
I think you're right. I love you. Thank you. I'm so happy to see you again.
I'm happy to see you as well.
Yeah.
This smacks of insincerity, I have to say.
It's progress, though.
Yeah, at least you're talking to each other.
Yeah.
In Paris was very difficult.
Yeah, because we were on opposites.
And also, he runs on a different voltage system than the French system.
It's true. It gets me very irritated.